church family, what I want to do now is just take an opportunity to kind of keep you updated on where we are as a church and what's happening with this entire COVID-19 and the reopening and all that's taking place. And so I just kind of want to give you an idea of what we as a church are thinking and doing. And so let me just catch you up quickly. First, by just reminding you that we have sent out emails to the governor, to the county supervisor, to our local assemblymen and senators, and we have requested that they would consider the churches as essential so that that would move us up in the timeline. Let me tell you what it looks like right now if you haven't heard. I'm going to say this quickly because I'm repeating from last week. Very simply, we currently in LA County in California are in phase three, which means we aren't even going to be considered for opening until August, from what the governor kind of hinted at a couple weeks ago. However, since then, there's been some discussion that maybe that moves a little more. I'll tell you in a moment what reopening looks like, but let me tell you about some letters I received recently. So we sent a letter to the county supervisor and received this email back. Thank you for your email to our office regarding the reopening of religious services. The California Resilience Roadmap includes in-person religious services in stage three. The state sets the threshold for LA County, and our orders cannot supersede the state's unless the county's orders are stricter. While we understand the importance of religious services, we also have to minimize opportunities for gatherings of different households in slower, reopen higher risk environments with adaptations and limits on size of gatherings. Please note that we still encourage religious services to be conducted remotely, virtually, for your members to stay connected. Should there be any changes in the state's roadmap regarding religious services, I will let you know. Sincerely, Office of Supervisor Catherine Barger. So that was the email I got back, and maybe you've got that back because if you sent out your emails and your letters to her, the front page of our website on the bottom is an encouragement for you to send your own letter to our various leaders. It's got addresses and emails for you to do that too. However, on Friday night, I got a phone call directly from Chuck Bostwick. He is the local liaison for Catherine Barger here in the Antelope Valley. And he told me that literally the day before, Catherine Barger asked the county council and the public health director, that's Dr. Barbara Ferrer, who you see in all the interviews and everything, he asked the two of them to get together to consider a way to bring the Antelope Valley under different conditions from the rest of LA County for the reopening phases. So in other words, our county supervisor has asked these two people to get together to figure out what we could do and possibly present a proposal to this county and then to the state that would allow the Antelope Valley, because we're in a whole different setting than, of course, downtown LA, to reopen early. So let that be the top of your prayer list. Now, let me just run through some things quickly for you so you can have an idea of what this means, okay? Even if we got the go-ahead, the minimum that we as Cornerstone Church would probably be able to open would be 4 weeks, and you're going to find out why it's going to take us 4 weeks and why we're working on it now. When we originally began to put this together, we didn't think, we thought August would be our starting point, but now things keep moving. We will not be opening on May 31st, as far as I know, at this point. I just don't think we can be ready at that point. You've probably heard a lot of rumors about churches wanting to make a show by opening on May 31st. At this point, the elders do not feel comfortable being part of that, especially if we haven't gotten official permission from the county. So just so you're aware of that. Now, let me tell you what reopen looks like, okay? It's a live stream service. So it's a service like this, a pre-recorded or a live stream service that's going to take place probably on site at the church, okay? But when we reopen, we can only allow 20% of the capacity of the church for people to attend. So that's about 30, 40 people for us at Cornerstone. So therefore, we'll have a live stream audience that we will invite to the church that day. And then we will provide, just as you're seeing now, the rest of you will be at home watching it at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning as well. You'll only be able to come to that service by invitation only, and we will let you know how to get that invite well in advance. That's part of the reason for the 4 weeks, because we've got to give you time to be ready to understand your part of it. It's almost going to be like a little contract. We send it to you, you agree to come to the service with your mask on and let us check your temperature and all of that stuff, and you agree to that, and then you show up and we make this work. So if we fill up one service, then the next week we'll line you up for the next service. This reopen right away. We'll have no child care whatsoever, no nursery, no children's ministry, just a worship service. Your kids will be able to come, but if they're above five, they're going to have to wear masks, and they'll be sitting on your lap or sitting next to you. There'll be spacing between family groups, 6 feet spacing between family groups. The 65-year-old and over are going to be encouraged to not attend at all until we get farther down the line. Okay? So, what do you do in the meantime? What are we encouraging you to do? Okay, we want to encourage you, first of all, to send out the letter to the government officials to request the church become essential. Be friendly, be polite, and get the details on the webpage and take care of that, okay? Make it an email. You've got emails there if you want to. Okay, we want you to become part of the team we need to help, okay? So I want you to email me on the front of the page, of the webpage. It says email the pastor. So you can email the church or email the pastor. What I want you to do is I want you to email me or text me, 916-4062, and just tell me I'm in or we're in. And I don't, high school on up, we need you to be part of our team. What does this team look like? Okay, the team looks like people who will take over sanitizing the church before and after the service and during it if the bathrooms are used. We need a full team for that. We need a team of parking lot attendants, people who will help people park with respectful distance, make sure they don't get out of their car and crowd someone else too close, and then coming and helping them walk to the front of the church. See, all of these things we have to do and follow in order to continue to stay reopened, okay? We will need somebody to come and put chalk lines out in the parking lot. We'll need our health screeners. I'm calling them temperature takers. You're going to be using no-contact thermometers and making sure that everybody's temperature coming into the room is below a certain temperature. And they're going to be asked a lot of questions to make sure you haven't been around somebody who's been exposed recently and all of those things. We need somebody to help make signs so we can direct the flow of traffic both driving in and walking out. We need the supplies on hand, including masks, hand sanitizers, and no-contact thermometers. And we need somebody to make a couple of offering drop boxes that are hands-free that people can just drop their offering in coming into the church or going out of the church. Okay? I need you to become part of that team. If you've kept up with me at all, we're looking at 20 people minimum that we need to be a part of that team. Okay? And since the 65-plus can't even attend the service, hello, under 65, we need you. Okay? So sign up and make this work. Okay? You'll be part of kind of finalizing how we do it, what it looks like, putting the plan together, okay? So please give us a call, send me a text, email me, let me know you're in, okay? Just a reminder that throughout this entire time, we will continue our Sunday morning 11 a.m. online service until we can come back to whatever normal will look like at that point.